Come get a sneak peek at what's new in Azure Data Studio, specifically related to notebooks, notebooks views, and open in Azure Data Studio. Learn more this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Julie, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Julie, thanks so much for joining us again.
Hi, Anna. It's nice to be here, and it's good to see you.
It's great to have you here, Julie, and always exciting because you're always talking about the latest and greatest things in Azure Data Studio, as well as notebooks, and everyone knows I love notebooks, so this is going to be a great topic. I'm excited. You're going to be telling us about something new, and one of those things is notebook views. So you already have my interest. Can you tell us, like, what are notebook views, why are they useful, and how do we get started?
Of course, yeah. So this is super hot. This is super new. So let's see how we go today. So essentially, when we start thinking about notebooks, we notice that a lot of folks are actually using notebooks for a lot of analysis. And at the end of the day, they want to share the outcome or the conclusion really easily, really simply to the consumers of that data. So it could be business users as an example, or perhaps your managers. And of course, when they look at notebooks like this, as you see on the screen, you would see that there's a lot of, you know, details, a lot of kind of, say, for example, code, and then this, you know, result set like this. And then towards the end, if I scroll down a little bit, you'll see some kind of chart, which is kind of nice. Now, imagine you're a consumer of this notebook. Do they really need to read all that, or would that be a cognitive overload, right? So here comes notebook views. So this is one that I have created earlier, which is called Retail Quick View. So it just talks about, hey, this is the top 10 rows of the data that we'll be showing, using today. And then here's the chart. So that is it. And then it works for SQL notebooks as well as Python or PowerShell, if you have any charting for that. Let's take a look one way it's actually coming from Python. So I've got Plotly here. So, you know, coming from Python, right? So I can still interact with it. I can zoom in, right? And then I can also go home as an example. And yeah, so less cognitive overload for your consumers.
That's awesome. I mean, I can think of so many uses for this, whether it's like you said, presenting to an audience, to your team, to your manager, even like in like a demo scenario, POC sort of scenario. But it's so nice to just kind of bring out all those, only the cells you really want other people to see, in a sense, for this. Yeah. Like, how hard is it to create these?
It's actually pretty straightforward. You notice that, let me just go reset to the previous view. Let me just exit this. Okay. So you'll notice there's a new button on the top here called Editor. So when you click on that, there's a drop-down menu. This is where you create a new view. So obviously, if you have created a new one, it will show on the bottom here. But let's create new view. And then it will actually add all the cells to this canvas. And now what you can do next is just essentially delete the ones that you don't want. For example, these ones here. And then if you want to add new ones, oops, you know, for example, I've remove too many, so then you can go to insert cells, and then this is where you can start adding new cells as an example.
Whoa, that is cool.
Yeah, and then of course this is not readable, right? So you want to make sure that you resize, etc., to kind of make sure that the visualization kind of fits. So yeah, so that's it. That's how you use the notebook view.
Wow, that's really cool. It seems really easy to use. And like, just a quick question, like, if I like delete some cells in the view, that doesn't mean that like my everything's gonna break, because they're gonna run as part of the normal notebook. Is that the right way to think about that?
Yeah, correct. So what happens is it's just a essentially as if you're pinning the cell, so it won't take away anything from the original notebook. And if you want to run, say for example, let's use this one, you can simply click run all and we'll start updating or refreshing all the views as well.
Oh, because it'll run everything in the back and just send the updates to the cells I wanted to see to the front. Mm-hmm. Wow, that's so cool.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. So, I'm going to have to start playing with this. So that's notebook views. Very cool. Hot off the press. So folks should go check those out. You know, Julie, I know y'all are always working on like really exciting stuff on the team. Is there anything else you could share with us? Like any sneak peeks or things that are really, really hot off the press?
Okay, so besides notebook views, let's take a look at this one. This is through collaboration with the CSS folks. So those are the support engineers for SQL Server. And you know that SQL Server has been around for a long time, and we've got a lot of great documentation in terms of how to troubleshoot certain things, including, for example, this one, full transaction log. So when you go to SQL Server docs and you search for this full transaction log, if I remember correctly, it's error number 9002, you will see an open in Azure Studio button so that when you click on it, it will show you the notebook directly in Azure Data Studio. So the prerequisite is you need to have Azure Data Studio installed on your machine first. Now, Anna, if you remember, we were talking about Control-C, Control-V. So this is essentially reducing that Control-C, Control-V activity that you might do, right? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's so easy. You think about it, you like go to your favorite search engine, you're searching for an error, you find the docs page and open Azure Data Studio, connect to my database or server, and there you go. This is really cool.
Yeah, so we have done only two at this time because we wanted to get feedback. So folks, please do go to this aka.ms link or use the QR code to read more about how you can or how you can learn more about the experiences and then how you can try out the two SQL Server docs that we've converted. And if this picks up really well, then we want to, of course, make sure we can automate this more or generate more kind of notebook equivalent for a lot more SQL Server docs and perhaps even more other docs.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thanks so much, Julie, for showing us notebook views, which were very cool, and I'm going to go play with them. And also this open in Azure Data Studio right from the SQL Docs. I see a lot of use cases for both of these scenarios. So it's cool to see how y'all are really like, you know, investigating what our customers need and are asking for and then are putting it out there really fast. Any final like tips or tricks you want to share before we wrap?
That's a good question, but I would say just try it Azure Data Studio. If you want to know more about the latest bits that we're working on, always try the Azure Data Studio Insiders. You get a sneak peek of what we're working on. So yeah, so that's my final tip for today.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Julie. This has been a great episode. Always an exciting one. To our viewers, go check out the resources. We'll put a link to them in the description. Play with notebooks. They're really cool, really fun, and also really effective for making you more efficient at your job. So definitely go check them out. Leave us a comment and let us know what you're doing with notebooks and some of these new capabilities. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.